Hello and welcome to Light for Living. Light for Living is a ministry of Lighthouse Bible Baptist Church, completely supported by our members. I'm Joshua Griffin, the assistant pastor at Lighthouse Bible Baptist Church, and I'm here live in the studio with Senior Pastor James Gugino, and we are going to be bringing you a broadcast today covering Bible prophecy.
All right, thank you, Josh. We appreciate that. And we're glad to be with you this afternoon and really excited about the topic today as we study prophecy. Our goal, once again, and our goal also, as it was last week, so we talked about science in the Bible, we talked about prophecy in the Bible. And what we're doing is we're showing you that the Bible is vindicated by itself. And prophecy proves that the Bible is the Word of God. There are many skeptics out there who want to try to disprove the Bible and say the Bible isn't true. But if you are a reasonable person who are not spiritually blinded, you're open to truth, you will understand that the Bible is the Word of God and it can be trusted with your soul. We're not going to give you a preaching message today. It's more teaching as it was like last week. But we once again want to give you some information. Hopefully it'll strengthen your faith. It certainly should strengthen your faith in the God of heaven who gave us a book, who gave us a book so that we could trust him, we could know his plan for our life, we can rely on his shed blood for us. And so we hope you enjoy it. As we go into the Word of God, we give you some facts about prophecy, and we just like to lift up the Word of God. And so as the Bible does, it lifts up itself. Now we're going to go back and forth, me and Josh. That's going to read us some verses in Isaiah 46, 9 through 11, as we talk about prophecy. And why don't you read that for us, Josh?
Yeah, Isaiah 46, 9 through 11. The Bible says, "Remember the former things of old, for I am God, and there is none else. I am God, and there is none like me, declaring the end from the beginning, and from ancient times the things that are not yet done, saying, My counsel shall stand, and I will do all my pleasure. Calling a ravenous bird from the east, the man that executeth my counsel from a far country, yea, I have spoken it, I will also bring it to pass, I have purposed it, I will also do it."
That's great, Josh. And why don't you make some comments about declaring the end from the beginning as it relates to prophecy?
Well, in these verses, the Lord is saying that here that he declares the end from the beginning, basically telling us that he can tell the future. And that would verify the accuracy of the Bible, because the Bible claims to be God's Word. If it is God's Word, it's a message that he gave us, and it shows that he is, because he can declare the end from the beginning, because he can tell the future, that he is outside of our time and space domain. So we know that when a prophecy that he gives comes true later on down the road, we know that he is true and he is completely trustworthy and faithful.
Absolutely, absolutely. Someone defined prophecy as this: prophecy is history written in advance. Let me say that again. Prophecy is history written in advance. And so God tells us the end at the beginning. And we're going to be discussing today some of the prophecies that Jesus fulfilled, and how that once again vindicates the fact that he was God, that God gave us the Bible, and we can trust it. He gave us the end at the beginning. And so we're gonna look into that. Josh, if you read 2 Peter chapter 1, 16 through 19, it explains that we can trust the Word of God even more. Peter says, "I can trust more about the Bible and its prophetical truths than I can when I even saw Jesus in the Mount of Transfiguration." Let's read that as it brings some clarity to that.
2 Peter 2, 16 through 19, or 1, 16 through 19 says, "For we have not followed cunningly devised fables when we made known unto you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, but were eyewitnesses of his majesty. For he received from God the Father honor and glory, when there came such a voice to him from the excellent glory, This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. And this voice which came from heaven we heard when we were with him in the holy mount. We have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto ye do well that ye take heed, as unto a light that shineth in a dark place, until the day dawn and the day star arise in your hearts."
And so he says we have a more sure word of prophecy, more sure word than what he saw at the Mount of Transfiguration with his own eyes. You and I can trust the Word of God. And that's what we want to talk about. Now, Tim LaHaye writes in his book, Charting the End Times, he writes six reasons why we should study Bible prophecy, and we're going to give you seven. And the first one he talks about is prophecy acquaints us with the most important subject of the ages. You say, boy, what's that most important subject of the ages? The most important subject of the ages is God's plan for man. Folks want to know that. Hopefully you want to know that. What does God want for me? What does God have for me? This kind of thing. And so prophecy acquaints us with these important things. It explains the Lord Jesus Christ coming on the scene and showing us what he has planned for us, not just in salvation, but in judgment, like through the tribulation, through his millennial reign after the tribulation, and these kinds of things, and so forth. And so prophecy acquaints us with these important subjects. Secondly, studying Bible prophecy convinces us that there really is a God. I mean, really, there's no other way this book could have gotten to us unless God gave it to us. We're going to give you some prophecies, their fulfillment, and there is no way man could have ever done this. Even if it was tried to be done on purpose, it would have never happened. Only God can truly reveal the future. And through this, we are affirmed that the Bible is the Word of God and that there really is a God in heaven. And he really loves you, and he died for you. Do you know that? Number three, the literal fulfillment of prophecy teaches us that prophecy should be interpreted literally. There are so many people who want to allegorize the Bible, and so what they do is they create confusion in the body of Christ. They cast doubt on the Word of God. Did God really mean what he said and say what he meant? And they want to question these kinds of things. But Bible prophecy tells us that the Bible is to be interpreted literally. When Jesus was to be born of a virgin, that was a literal prophecy. When he was supposed to be born at Bethlehem, that was a literal prophecy because it was literally fulfilled. Don't let anyone try to talk you out of the literal interpretation of the Word of God. Fourthly, the study of Bible prophecy prepares the Christian to avoid the deceptions of the many false prophets that are arising in our day. And so we can be very, very careful as we look to the Word of God and the predictions of the false, God's prophecies. It protects us from false prophecies and false prophets. Jesus says in Matthew 24, there's going to be many Christs. They're going to come in my name and say all these things. He says, don't believe them. And so forth. So, the best way to avoid being deceived by false teachers is to know the prophetic teachings of the Word of God. For example, there's many false teachers who say that Israel was never going to become a nation, and God's all done with Israel. But in fact, that is a lie, that is false, but that is propagated today. And so, prophecy is very important for our study. Fifthly, the study of prophecy promotes an evangelistic church. Hey, if you're an evangelistic church, it's probably because you know that we're in the end times. And boy, we need to be evangelistic. Someday, Jesus says, I'm going to come back for my church, then the tribulation's going to happen. Prophecy teaches us that. And so we must warn people about God's judgment, how that God hates sins, and he judges sins. And if the sinner is unforgiven, they will have to pay in a godless hell forever. Heaven is the presence of God. That's what makes heaven heaven. But what makes hell hell is the absence of God. And boy, if you're not saved, you want to get saved. Anyhow, the study of prophecy promotes an evangelistic church. Folks, do you care enough about the Lord and his love for souls? Do you care about your loved ones enough to tell them that Jesus died for them and Jesus loves them? Because really, we know from the Bible what it says about a lost person's future. We know the end from the beginning, that lost people go to hell and they burn forever and ever and ever, having to pay for their own sins.